guys, this is Virgil. Welcome to WeSupply. I want to show you today one of my favorite websites for curbside. This company is obviously Target, as you can see it on the screen. What I really like about them is that they have an app where when you go and pick up the product, they basically do location tracking. And as soon as you arrive at the store, somebody's already waiting outside, you know, to hand you the products. So it's super, super cool. There were many times, you know, I was just pulling into the parking lot and they were walking out. And I want to share with you guys this experience. And I also want to walk you through how they do everything and what is really cool about, you know, their entire experience and how they promote it, because that's another story. So let's get started. This is the homepage, right? As you can see, I'm in incognito. So they basically don't know really much about me. But what I can see here is that they already do a detection based on my IP address. And this store is not really the closest, but close enough. So I can also come here and I can basically update, you know, like the location and select the store I want. So let's select the one, the art museum, as my store. Cool. And I can change it anytime. Also, here, right in the header, you can see that they emphasize on order pickup, same day delivery, and drive up. And if you go to here, they very nicely explain, you know, like how order pickup works. You know, you can look up stores nearby. They can show products that are available for delivery. Same thing. And for drive up, which is curbside, which is my favorite experience, it's really nice. Everything is explained here. Now, let me just show you this. So I created an account, a brand new account, and in their welcome email, they advertise this. So no contact, pick up, you know, more so the target circle. But what I want to highlight here is they take every chance to tell you that they have curbside implemented and it's a no contact, it's safe, it's good for you. So just go and pick it up. Really cool. Okay, now let me show you a few other things that I like. So for example, if I go to categories, let's say man clothing, whatever. Oh my goodness, so many categories. Here on the category page, you can see that they do the same thing. So I can filter this page based on in-store pickup, whatever is available at my store. Okay, not much. everything that's available for same day delivery. Okay, basically they don't do clothing for same day delivery. What you can buy in store, and basically what you can buy in store and pick up is mostly the same, and what's available for shipping. And they can basically ship you anything. So really, really cool implementation that you can see here. You can shop each store directly from, you know, the category page, and you can see what's available and how you can purchase it. And, you know, like same day everywhere. So everywhere you look, they advertise that you can do curbside, you can do pickup. Really cool. Okay, so I have here a few products that I want to purchase to demonstrate how they do everything. And I'm trying to make this, as always, as complex as possible for them. So let me show you my strategy. So I'm going to get this, whatever, the Rubbermaid storage containers. And I want to pick this up, but I want to pick it up from the Philadelphia Washington Square location. And the reason why I want to pick it up from there is because it's in store. This location is basically on, you know, Chestnut Street, which is very, very busy street usually. And, you know, this is Google Street, you know. Here you can see that they have location. You know, they have parking spots available somehow, although this is a bus line. So I'm not really sure how are they going to manage curbside pickup here. Where am I going to stop? On the middle of the street? Bus stop? Not sure. So let's give it a test. This is going to be interesting. But you can also change the location very easily. So you can see all the locations that have it available And you can even filter, so only show me locations that have it available or whatever. Show me all the locations. You can change the store. You can see store details right here, which I actually really like. I think it's really cool. One of my favorite ways of shopping, you know, looking up stores. So cool. I'm gonna do this and I add it to the car, pick it up on one of the busiest streets in Philadelphia. Cool. Next product. So this is what I want to pick up from the art museum location. And the reason why I want to pick it up from there, because a few days ago, I actually wanted to buy this product and they didn't have it in stock. And I want to show you how they communicate when basically they oversell at a location. They go to pick that product, but they realize they don't have that product. And then, you know, they basically communicate with you like, we're sorry. Maybe they restocked it, although only three left, so I doubt. Let's see. Hopefully I can show you that. And okay. I also really like this. So check this out. I can buy this product three ways, right? I can deliver it for myself, same day delivery, and store pickup. Like, how cool. You can basically see every option of making a purchase right here. And what is even cooler, and if I ship it to myself, so this is okay, if I get it same day delivery, you know, I can get it as soon as 1 p.m. today. Right now it's 11:36 a.m. so basically in 2 hours. But if I ship it to myself, wherever, you know, not sure why this is not the same time as that, but probably comes from a completely different location, and it takes whatever more, doesn't matter. I see exactly when the product is going to arrive directly on the product page. So if I buy it today, they don't tell me like, oh, it takes 2-3 days to ship it, whatever nonsense. They tell me exactly, I'm going to get it by Tuesday, February 2nd. Really cool. And you know, it's free shipping if I purchase over $35. Cool. Anyways, I'm going to pick this up at the location because I'm expecting this product to not be in stock, and they are going to oversell. And at that point, I want to show you that. If it works out, great. If not, whatever. Cool. Okay. Third product. So this one is going to be picked up as well. But what I want to do here, I want to ship this product to a store that, basically ship to a store where they don't have it currently. So I will have to wait a few days to get this product, which is fine. So I will say Philadelphia Art Museum, they don't have it. And I'm going to be, so they are going to ship it to this store and it's going to be available, you know, as soon as Wednesday, February 3rd. So let's do that. So I'm going to ship it to the store. Oh, and one more product I want to buy. I want to ship this product home, right? So again, same thing. I will get it Tuesday, February 2nd. I can change up the zip code. This is quite accurate. Not exactly good, but close enough, considering because I didn't input it anywhere. So cool, still that. Okay, and I ship it. So let's go to the cart. You guys ready? Okay, Target, are you up for a challenge? So, four products in my cart. I really like how they basically showcase here, you know, like the, you know, like a summary of my order. I'm going to pick up orders, right? One item from Washington Square, one of the busiest streets, two items from Philadelphia Art Museum. One, I'm expecting it to be out of stock, and the other product, I'm shipping it to this store, so I will have to wait a few days until they actually ship this product. And the last product basically is going to be sent to my home. Cool. Really nice how they have here, you know, the cart page. I can see each product, you know, I can still change up, you know, if I wanted order pickup or ship it home, when it's going to arrive. Ready within 2 hours. If I standard ship it home, you know, it's going to arrive Tuesday, February 2nd. I repeat this a million times. Nobody cares about 2 to 3 business days shipping. Like, who knows what's a business days this day? Like, there can be a holiday, it can be a weekend, it can be whatever. What's your processing time? I don't understand that, and I don't even care. Tell me when the product arrives. And this is how basically everybody does it. Amazon does it this way. REI, I showed it to you guys the other day. Target, it's the best way. Straightforward, there are no questions. There's no reason for me to reach out to customer service to ask them, like, when is this going to arrive? It's clearly stated. So this product, order pickup ready in 2 hours. This product, order pickup ready in 2 hours. I'm expecting this to not be available. Okay. And this product, I'm going to ship it home. No, I'm going to ship it to the store, and then it's going to arrive Wednesday, February 3rd. And the last product, I'm going to ship it home, and it's going to arrive Tuesday. Cool. Really nice. So this is really cool. I don't have to decide how I want to check out, because basically inside, as soon as I get the order confirmation and, you know, the product is ready for pickup, I can choose within the app, you know, or switch it, you know, if I want to drive up or actually go inside the store and pick it up. Cool. Let's check out. Oh, I also like this. They have the cart number here. So if I have an issue with this checkout process, basically I can call customer service and I can tell them, hey, my cart number is this one, and they can probably see all the products and everything I'm trying to achieve. Okay, let's check out. So again, here really nicely, I can see again what I'm trying to achieve. And I have to insert my delivery address for the products that I'm delivering home and the payment info. So stay tuned. I'll be back. Okay, I just want to call this out. So during this process, when I'm actually entering my delivery address, my pickup information, my payment info, right? They have this section for order pickup info, and here, you know, I can tell who is going to pick up this order, right? So the order is going to be ready within 2 hours, whatever. I need to bring my valid ID, which can be a driver license or a password. To be quite honest, they are not checking these days these things anymore. They just walk up, they see the description, it's more contactless. Or you can go inside the store. And I can here tell them, like, who is going to pick up this order? Like, who's the person? In this case, it's going to be me, but I can also add another person. And I can add them here, and that person gets the notifications for emails as well when the product is ready for pickup. So really cool, I really like it. It's a really cool way to basically, I might not be available at that time, you know, or I might think that my day is open, but that's actually not going to be like that. So really cool to be able to add an additional person to pick it up. Okay, I'm going to add this info and I'll be back. Okay, now I added all the payment info and I'm going to place this order. So I'm really wondering, what do you guys think? Is the thank you page going to be custom to the way I checked out? So saying like in-store pickup, whatever. Okay, let's see. Yep, looking good. Thank you for your order. We send you a confirmation to the email. It's really nice. I always like when they mention again, you know, to which email address they're going to send this. If you need to change, that's really cool. So sometimes I realize I purchased something by mistake, or I purchased the wrong product after I placed the order. I really like that you can actually still go in and still cancel the order, make modifications to the order, etc. So I don't have to call customer service to do all these actions. And I'm going to show you how you can do that. Okay, I can take a survey. Really cool. And of course, they are going to tell me, you know, like, order pickup at the 2 locations, what do I have to bring, all that stuff, and the shipping address. Really nice. Cool. View order details. So if I come here, I can see that I have the button to cancel this item. which is really nice. I'm not going to cancel it because I want to see all the notifications and how they manage everything. But it's really cool because I can modify the order, or I can add here still, you know, an alternative person, order placed. Okay, really cool. Really cool FAQ right here recently. Okay, so far I'm liking this a lot. I really like that you can change the order and I don't have to call customer service. I think that is a crucial element that most retailers are avoiding to do, but it's actually good. It's really good to be able to do that. Okay, let's see order confirmation. Thank you for shopping with us. Here's your order. Cool. Okay, nicely marked up. Gmail already detected all the info. So this is what Gmail does. Basically, it adds you buttons, you know, you can... Okay, anyways, that's not important right now. So, thank you for your order. Standard shipping. It's going to arrive February 2nd. Very nice order confirmation page. Processing for pickup. This product is going to be ready to be picked up shortly. Same here. I'm expecting this to be out of stock. I'm going to ship this to a store, shipping to a Target store. And where's the product I'm shipping home? Oh, the first one. Cool. So this is looking really good. Really, really good. Really nice. And I can view the order directly from here. And pulls that up. Okay, this is really cool. I just want to show you this. So same as I showed the other day in my RAI review, you can actually see here all your online purchases and all your in-store purchases. So even if I go to a store and I basically make a purchase with a credit card, you know, it's going to pull up here all the orders made with that credit card. You see, add a credit card here. It's really nice. They basically identify customers based on credit card numbers. So this is really cool. Maybe other variables as well, but I love how they unify, you know, the experience of online shopping with in-store shopping, and they bring all your orders in one place. And that is crucial these days. Like, I want to see everything I purchased in the store and how much time I have to return that product. There's no question about like proof of purchase. It's just, it's a very, very clean way. And this is what customers are going to expect, because all the big brands, Target does it, REI does it, and many other brands do the same thing. So it's really cool. This is coming. And if you don't have it, make sure you implement it. So I'm going to wait now for my orders to be ready to be picked up. And as soon as I get that notification, I'm going to go to the store, pick up the products, and I'm going to record all that interaction. And I'm really curious, how are they going to manage curbside pickup on one of the busiest streets where there's literally no parking. Like, I can probably stop here on the bus lane, but it's going to be tricky. We'll see. I'll be back. Okay, guys, so actually this was a little bit disappointing because I was expecting to be able to go and pick up the product as curbside, which is not the reality. So this location, as I said, is in the middle of the city, very busy street. There's no way to park there. And normally I would be able to switch from the app this order from pickup into a curbside, but as you can see, there's no option for that. So the button is actually missing to convert this order from in-store pickup into curbside. So this is something that Target should consider and fix on their website, so you're not expecting to go there and do curbside and you can't and you cannot park, and you, who wants to pay for parking? Nobody. Anyways, this is something that they should fix. Overall, the page is really nice. I can see each product when it's going to arrive. I can see this one, for example, February 2nd. The next one, whatever. And yeah, I will actually have to cancel this item because I don't want to go there to pick it up. I don't want to pay for parking. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel it. So I select the product I want to cancel. And then the reason of my cancellation, I basically no longer need this product. And I submit it. So yeah, that's about it. I will have to go again and wait for a few more days until I receive the product at the Philadelphia Art Museum store, where I know for sure I can do in-store curbside pickup. So as soon as I get that product, February 3rd, I'm gonna go and show you guys how to do that. So stay tuned. Take care. Okay, good news. The order is ready for pickup for the Target order that I placed at the Art Museum store. I can see which store. I can get the directions, I guess. I can see the product. And I want to show you this entire experience from the mobile app. So let me just pull that up. Here's the app and here's the order, right? So okay, this is the thing, and show barcode, and you can see here I can change it from order pickup to drive up. Come on. Okay, to drive up. And now I'm saying I'm on my way, and I'm going to type in here, Ford, whatever, it's good enough. And now I am basically on my way, and as you can see there, you can see the location is enabled and I'm taking off right now. As soon as I get there, I'm gonna hit I'm here. So let's go. There's a little bit of snow outside, so that's gonna be challenging. Okay, so it's really cool. I arrived and I didn't have to push the I'm here button. They automatically detect that I arrived. And keep your windows up. This is my PIN, basically, that I can show them. The only problem is there's a snowstorm, and I'm not sure if you guys can see, but I cannot actually go. I cannot request the product to be, delivered curbside, because they are out of service right now. They are not doing curbside, I guess because it's snowing. So yeah, questionable weather. They should say this prior, honestly. Wait. Papa, the lady is coming. Although they are saying they are not coming, they are doing it. Yeah, poor woman. Okay, anyways, so let's see. They are coming right now. Okay, this was fast. Hello.
Hi.
Virgil?
Yep.
6114. Thank you very much. Have a good one. Okay. Cool. So this was quite fast. Fast, less than a minute. She was quite pissed. Okay. Thank you, lady. Yep, she was not really happy because she had to come out. But anyways, thanks for driving up. Your receipt for your account. I can check here the product that I picked up, and I can just hit done. And now that I hit done, it shows that the product got picked up and this one got delivered. And the last product is this one, which is going to be for tomorrow, that I will need to come back and pick it up. And this product I canceled. Let's see if we received any kind of... Yep. Hooray! Your order was picked up on Monday. And you paid this. And this is the product that I picked up. Okay. What else I received? Okay, that was it actually. Cool. So this was one of the best experiences. Although they said they're not doing pickup, they did. And the pickup time was quite fast. The weather conditions are quite horrible outside. Let's do this. Let's see if the brands are delivering what they promise, regardless of weather conditions. Okay, I'll be back. Cool. So now that I received one of my items, so this product is actually got shipped. I received this notification, product got shipped, standard shipping where it delivers, all that tracking. I have a little scan bar, you know, that I can scan to go to the store and return it. Really cool. And I can actually track this order. Now, if I track this order, it basically opens a tracking page that has all the information regarding this shipment. So you can see it here. This is really cool. And now I can actually go and even return this product. So let me show you how, what's the current status of my order. So this order was placed January 28th. As you guys know, this product was expected not to be in the store, and I opted for it to be shipped. And it was estimated to be shipped, you know, and to arrive by Tuesday, February 2nd. That did not happen. I did not receive any notification that this product was shipped. It still says preparing for shipment. Although I received this one, the second product, so this is cool. I can see the tracking info. It's all here, delivered. Yes, I received the product, and I picked this up. It's all good. I got the notification that the product got picked up. All cool. Now let's do a return on the products that I can actually do a return. Still waiting on this one. When I get it, I get it. Who knows? Okay, I can select to do return to store or return to mail. By mail, let's do one and one. Return by mail, let's start here. I select this product, return reason. Okay, no, I changed my mind. Oh, this is bad. If it's too long, yeah. Okay, good enough. So that is the product that I'm going to return. I can return this as well, but I'm gonna select this one to be returned in store. And now I can continue. Come on. Replace item, not eligible for a refund. This item is, oh, is only eligible for a refund, yes. And full refund, yes, sounds good. Share your feedback, show us what's wrong. I can upload images. Good, that's cool. And I can add, you know, some comments. Okay, that's all good. I'm not gonna do that. And I submit it. So let's see what happens. Oh. Okay. I don't need to return this item anymore, and a refund will be credited back to my account. That's cool. Now I feel bad. Now I really feel bad. Okay. I guess I got the product for free now. So let's do the other. Completely are waiting on return. Okay, so I'm going to get my money back here. That's really nice of them. Let's return this product as well. Return to a store. So I can just return it to a store and scan this barcode. That's really cool. So let's do the other one. I want to see because they generate the return label. I hope they do. Okay. Change my mind. Continue. For refund, continue. Come on. Okay, good. So I have to return this product. Okay, that's fine. After we received items. So that's cool. They even offer an option. So they basically This is really nice. So probably for the other product, because it's just too cheap, you know, they don't want to go through the hassle of processing that return, whoever, whatever, you know, it's a kid product, who wants to reuse a kid product? Nobody. Anyways, they let you keep the item, but they issue the refund. Thank you, Target. That's really cool. And for the second item, this one, because, you know, it's like something more substantial, you know, they want you to return it. And as soon as they receive the item, you know, they're going to allow, they're going to provide the refund. So it's really cool. I'm going to print the free return label. Okay, let's see how this looks. And I can choose. Woo, that's cool. I can choose if I want the FedEx or I want the UPS. Pack your item, drop it off of the package. Request your browser setting, allow pop-ups, return, okay. Find the drop-off location. What happens? It opens this. Ugh. Okay. I guess it's the same. Yep, same behavior. Okay, let's pick up one. Let's do UPS. Ready? Okay, it's gonna be UPS. Okay. One more time. Oh, pop up. My God, what happened? Sorry guys, sometimes I feel like I don't know how to use the computer. Allow pop-ups, but that's stupid. Just open it in a new window or something. Ah, finally. Cool. Oh my God. What happens if I just want to email this to a friend? My, this is bad. Okay, I'm gonna hit print. Maybe it keeps the page. Oh, it closed it again. Okay, now that's stupid. Okay, I really don't like that. And let's see the email confirmation. Return has been started. Thank you very much for that one. You guys can hear my printer, return label. Maybe the FedEx one. Just open it in a new window. How do I even undo this? Like, you see, like, if somebody doesn't know how to do that, it doesn't work. They have a, they're struggling. Okay, this is like a freaking empty page. Let me get the paper to see what's happening there. Okay, I'm back. So I printed out both. This is the FedEx return label. I'm not sure why they even give you that option to print FedEx if you already printed out one. Okay, anyways, that's confusing and stupid, I think. Okay, this one printed out. So I want to show you guys. This is a return label for £6. Again. And here I have, you know, the instructions with, you know, kind of like a packing slip. I think other brands do the packing slip way better. I think this is not the best way of doing it. But yeah, whatever. You know what's interesting? This feels like very similar to how Best Buy does it, this return label. It has the same reference numbers, like the order number and reference number 2, and yeah. I'm wondering if it goes back to the same place. Anyways, This section was a little bit confusing with the pop-ups. I think they should not use pop-ups because the pop-ups, and they even call it out. Like, clearly this is a problem. And how do I do and change that setting? Like, honestly, I have no idea how to do it. Probably if I take 1 minute, you know, I figure it out, but I don't want to take that minute. And it creates more issues than it helps. It should just open a new window, and that's about it. And it would be much, much easier. Yeah, and as soon as you generate one return label, just don't generate another one, or allow to generate another one, but then actually generate the label. Yeah, now anyways, overall, thank you for the free return. And I don't know what to say. Overall, good experience. Like, it's definitely a good experience, but it has some issues. Like, every company has, but you know, they can work them out. Overall, good. I really like Target, and I think they are a good benchmark. You know, how curbside pickup should be done, how post-purchase experience should look like. Definitely getting, you know, a full refund, you know, without sending back the product. That's like a really pleasant experience, you know. So yeah, good job, Target. Good job. Some room for improvement. Take care. Bye-bye.